I'm Callie Heisman, Developer Advocacy Director here at DocuSign. Normally in our developer deep dives, we talk to other engineering teams within DocuSign about the tools and products that they're working on. But today is going to be fun. We're going to do something a little bit different and talk to one of our own engineers on the Dev Center. Today we're going to be talking about our new Developer Center. And for those of you who haven't visited it yet, you can go to developers.docusign.com and check it out and see all of the changes that we're going to be talking about here today. And joining me here today to talk about all of these new changes that we're doing is the lead engineer on the Developer Center team, Alex Cooper. Welcome, Alex.
Hey, thank you for having me.
No problem. We're excited to talk to you about this. So before we dive into the nuts and bolts here, I have to ask my first question, which is why? In my opinion, the Developer Center was already pretty perfect, of course. So why did we do this revamp?
Great question, and I agree. It achieved its original goal, which was to get us off of a traditional Drupal-based CMS and to use an in-house headless one instead. While it was running, we used this opportunity to gather feedback about our information architecture, performance, SEO, stuff like that, and then kind of channel what we learned to the new platform.
Yeah, and I know that this also came at a fortunate time for DocuSign, where we were doing an overall rebrand. And in addition to that, we got our own developer-specific branding that you guys were able to incorporate into the look and feel of the new Dev Center, correct?
Absolutely. And on top of incorporating the new UI, we felt it was a great opportunity to overhaul the UX in general.
Let's talk about under the hood, though. So aside from the sort of aesthetic and UX updates and changes, which are significant and which are awesome, let's talk about the major technical changes that you guys made. What are some of the major architectural decisions that you made for the new site?
So I would say the single largest one is the architecture under the hood, given that the old site was an isomorphic React app.
For those of you who are watching this and maybe don't know what that means, Alex, can you talk a little bit about an isomorphic app and sort of the significance of that?
Yeah, so your traditional React application, what happens is when your web server receives an HTTP request, that is when your page starts getting rendered. Isomorphism is a way to optimize this by offloading some of that rendering process onto the web server, so it's split between the client and the web server. However, even though we're optimizing it, we're not addressing the underlying root cause here.
Yeah, so I know we had some underlying performance issues that you guys were trying to address with this. Talk to me a little bit about that. You know, how were we able to address some of those problems with these changes?
Yeah, so when we started to hit scale, we were noticing large initial payloads as well as subsequent increases in that secondary rendering phase that you see in isomorphic apps. We found ourselves spending a lot of time handcrafting optimizations to deal with our infrastructure as opposed to building out new features. So one example of this was we converted a good portion of our site to static, which, even though it alleviated our immediate performance concerns, presented other challenges.
It sounds like you guys just got to the point where you just decided, chuck the whole thing, let's start over, and let's start with a better architecture. And in this case, for you guys, that meant a Jamstack, right? So talk to me a little bit about what is that tech stack and how is it helpful for you guys?
The real problem that we needed to solve was offloading this big render phase. And so one of the things that Jamstack does is it moves us to the build time. And what happens is that we do this pre-rendering and then produce a bundle of highly optimized HTML, CSS, and JavaScript and serve that from our production web servers instead.
You know, site speed is very important to developers when they're trying to get more information off the site and find the correct pages. So I know that made a big difference. Can you talk to me a little bit about some of the sections of the site that maybe previously were static, but were moving to more dynamic pages?
Yeah, so a big candidate for us back, when we made this transition to static was the e-signature REST API reference due to its sheer size. And so if we click around here, so here I'm at the old site, and as I'm clicking around, you'll notice that it's actually pretty snappy compared to maybe other regions. And that is because it is static HTML. In contrast, if we go to the new site and I click around, this is fully dynamic, and we're still seeing a similar performance. And this is extremely important for us because even though the performance of the static pages is great, it's going to hold us back from future development that we want to add in.
Can you tell me a little bit about maybe what some of those features would be? Like, what are we planning to put on some of these dynamic pages that we couldn't have before?
Yeah, so we have another product called the API Explorer, which is a tool that allows engineers to fire off API calls. One of the biggest things we want to do here is pull that into these pages so your developer can make these calls side by side to the documentation.
Awesome. So as I'm going through the reference documentation and I'm looking at individual endpoints, I will actually be able to test those out, see the requests and responses without ever leaving the documentation page, right?
Exactly. A little coder pad will take care of everything for you.
And I know we had some overall goals too, and just, you know, evolving the Dev Center and making some of these changes. Where are you guys really trying to go with this?
At a high level, it's a whole new philosophy of how we're looking at the site, right? Instead of being a repository for documentation, we really want to take this to the next level and create sort of a place where developers can come, try out new features of the DocuSign Cloud, and test out, you know, different tools and, you know, code right there on the site.
So really less of a documentation warehouse and something a little bit more fun and interactive for people to really test things out.
Exactly.
All right. Before I let you go, I would love for you to show me a demo here and just walk me through some of the workflows side by side so people can really get a feel for what has changed on the new Dev Center site.
So if I start with the old site here on the left, and I navigate to, you know, just eSignature REST API, you're going to start seeing this isomorphic behavior. You're going to see this momentary spinner that happens in the middle of the page and kind of this sort of two-phase rendering process. In contrast, if you go to the new site, and I'm going to do the same thing here, just navigate to, you know, APIs, eSignature REST API, and you'll notice that it's quite a bit snappier. We're not seeing this second spinner on every page load. And as we click further and further, this prefetching and caching behavior of our JAM platform really takes into effect, and we start getting near instantaneous page load times.
All right. Thanks for the demo, Alex, and thank you for joining us today.
Thank you, Kelly.
See you all at our next Developer Deep Dive.
If you liked that video, be sure to subscribe to our channel for the latest DocuSign developer content. If you want to see a specific topic in a future video, comment below. For everything else, visit the DocuSign Developer Center.